أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. الله أكبر 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 لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر لله الحمد. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد الفاتح لما أغلق والخاتم لما سبق ناصر الحق والحق والهادي إلى صراطك المستقيم وعلى آله حق قدره ومقداره العظيم. يا سيدنا يا رسول الله شفاعتك يا رسول الله محبتك يا رسول الله عفوك ورضاك يا رسول الله اشفع لنا عند الله عز وجل مبارك يوم الجمعة يا سيدنا يا رسول الله. اللهم بارك لنا ولحبيبك المصطفى سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم بيوم الجمعة يا رسول الله. يا رب أعنا أنت المستعان وبك نستعين يا الله. يا معين العاجزين أعنا يا الله نحن عبيدك العاجزين الضعف افتح علينا فتوح العارفين يا حبيبك المصطفى سيدنا محمد يا سيدنا رسول الله افتح علينا من عند الله فتح مبين من عندك يا سيدنا رسول الله مدنا مدد محمد من عندك مدد أهل بيتك الكرام صحابتك مدنا مدد من أنشاء عبد الله الداستاني ناظم الحقاني مدد أنشاء عبد الله الداستاني من أنشاء ناظم الحقاني مدد نسور يا سيدي مدد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. Don't listen to me. I am also listening as you are listening. Listen to the one whom they are addressing through me to all whom they are hearing and listening and also to me because by the Allah Almighty built up to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Rasulullah built up Islam and Sahaba and Sohba. The Sohba, and for this he didn't build it up on teaching or advising, but he built it up on Sohba, and for this he was always, all his life, he was with Sohba, with his Sahaba, and for this they are called Sahaba by their Sohba, by accompanying as a companion. Rasulullah was as a companion for them by Sohba. He was dressing them, advising them, teaching them without making them to feel that he is a teacher on them or forcing them or ordering them, but only building them up by Sohba to be all the time with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in familiarity, so that to know everyone what is his spiritual sickness, because the spiritual sickness lead to the physical sickness, and the physical sickness cannot be cured. Even you will take all kind of medicines, if Allah Almighty is not curing, never is cured. And the spiritual sickness, Allah saying, you must do your best to cure yourself from it, then I will be supporting you to be cured. But never you think that Allah will cure you from a spiritual sickness. Never Allah will change you from badness to goodness. Never Allah will change you from goodness to badness. Never Allah will be helping you if you don't want to help yourself. And for this Allah Almighty, the first thing descending on Rasulullah, even it is a pre-eternal knowledge and teaching from Rasulullah to all the manifestation of Allah Almighty and the lights. But the ayah in the Holy Quran, لا يغير الله ما بقوم حتى يغير ما بأنفسه. Never Allah Almighty will it change anyone or a crowd of people or a country or a city or all peoples. Never Allah will change them unless they are able to change themselves by themselves. Then Allah will help them to change to the better. If they want to change them to the bad, Allah will change them to the worst even. If they want to change from badness to goodness, Allah will help them and support to change them to goodness. Like this, Allah Almighty, like this saying in the Holy Quran, don't think that Allah Almighty will change you by overnight. You will be a bad one, you will be a good one, or you are a good one, make you a bad one, no. But this something coming from yourself, either to follow your mind, your satanic word, or to follow Allah Almighty and the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and to try to help yourself by changing yourself from badness to goodness, to cure yourself from the spiritual sickness, to be dressed by cureness from Allah Almighty. And for this Allah Almighty descending Holy Quran, saying this Holy Quran, it is a shifa, curing all kind of spiritual sickness. Because when your spiritual sickness is cured, then your physical sickness, your physical body will follow. The physical body like a shadow for the spiritual body. The physical body, Allah created it to be shadow for the soul. While the real body is the soul, the essence of the one, the humanity, the essence of humanity is the secret which Allah Almighty dressed as a soul, as a spirit in you. This is the real body. And the real senses and the hearts and the eyes and the tongue and the feeling and the ears, all they are in the spiritual, in the spirit, in the soul, on the spiritual body, not in this physical body. All these, they are only shadows reflecting the spiritual body. And for this, if you are not able to cure yourself through the suhbah of Rasulullah, through the suhbah of Awliyaullah, inheriting the secret of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, through Ahlul Baytul Nabi, through Sahaba of Rasulullah, never you will be cured from the spiritual sickness. Allah will not cure you. He say promising, I will not cure anyone. Unless you try to cure yourself, I will cure you. Because already I discern a dinner table, a table full with all kind of cureness. The Holy Quran, it is the table from Allah Almighty, which all in it, all the ayat, and all the greatest names of Allah Almighty, and all the 99 names, and the names of Allah Almighty, and the attributes of Allah Almighty, if you use them for every spiritual sickness, you will be cured. But who will guide you how to use them? You must have a guidance. If there is no guidance to guide you, never you can reach to where you want to reach. Today we were lost 1 hour because we don't have a guidance to guide us, and it takes 5 minutes, it took us 1.5 hours until we find a one to guide us to reach to the Zawiya. If there is no guidance, however you have spiritual power, will not be permitted by Allah Almighty to use it, to find it as a miracle. Must be through the ordinary channels. And for this, without a guidance to guide you in the holy ayat of the Holy Quran, the ayat and the divinely names of Allah Almighty, the divinely attributes of Allah Almighty, never you will find the remedy, the healing for your spiritual sickness. And this will reflect on your physical body, and for this you will be losing your life, and you're sick, and you will be totally sick. Diabetic, heart attack, stroke, all kind of miseries will come over the one. Why? Because he makes his spiritual body totally dead by interfering in and replacing himself by, instead to say tawakkal to Allah and to keep everything to Allah Almighty. He is the creator, he is the one program. He is the one to question, he is the one to interfere, he is the one to make everyone to act as he programmed him to act. We are in a theater, big theater, and everyone Allah making him to come to this theater, this earth, this planet, and to do in it or act in it according he was programmed by Allah Almighty in pre-eternal. And everyone doing how Allah Almighty programmed him, he is fulfilling his play, his acting as programmed, as an actress, and then how much he is perfecting what Allah created him, everyone will be saying to him, bravo. But everyone who interfering to cut from everyone what not to do how Allah Almighty programmed him, and to interfere and to block for him all the ways and all the programs which Allah programming him, then this one will be failing on this theater, and he would be a loser, and the one who interfering with him, he will be punished and will be a loser like him. And like this, Allah will send then all kind of spiritual sickness and physical sickness over the one. And for this, the awliyaullah, the Ahlul Baytul Nabi, the Sahaba of Rasulullah, they are the ones whom they are proud on everyone, prouder than everyone who make himself proud. Because Rasulullah say to be proud on a one who is making himself proud and never making his nose down is humbleness. Be proud on a one who is seeing himself, making himself proud. Be a one stopping the one who is interfering in the programming of Allah Almighty and programming of Rasulullah. Stop him and don't worry. Allah will support you. And Rasulullah say in the hadith, if you are not able and have power to stop him, by your hand, because by your hand means to use force, and this only for the rulers, or for the sultan, or for the khalif. If you are not able, then you must correct him and stop him by your tongue, by your tongue at least, to advise him, to make a sohbah for him, to see him his spiritual sickness, to stop him and to show him what remedy, what treatment, so that he will be cured from this spiritual sickness, so that his body will be safe, and Allah will save his physical body, and Allah will help him to be changed from badness to goodness. And even if not listening to the one, and he's so proud that he doesn't even accept an advice or a sohbah or to be seeing his sickness, and this sohbah and this advising by tongue, it is like a mirror. You put it in front of one to see himself. You cannot see yourself without a mirror. Anyone can see his face, his eyes, his eyebrows, his mustache, his lips, his ears without a mirror in front of him. Everyone, every morning, before anything, he used to face the mirror, to adjust his face, to adjust his body, to dress, so that to be outside the house handsome and be accepted by people. How about to be in the divine presence of Allah Almighty and Rasulullah, who facing you in every second, in every moment? How much you need a spiritual mirror to be in front of you, to show you all your sicknesses, all your badness, all your misbehaving, that you will be cleaning, brushing yourself, washing yourself, showering yourself, then dressing well, by repenting and zikrullah and astaghfirullah, to be appearing handsome in the eyes of Allah Almighty and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And for this, Rasulullah built up the Sahaba on Suhbah, because they used to be worshipping statues without feeling that they are doing something wrong, never changing from badness to goodness, always badness until Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah appearing him, and then he was turning them 360 degrees back to be looking at the mirror of Rasulullah to see how much they be well handsome in the eyes of Allah Almighty. And for this they were totally helping themselves to change themselves, that Rasulullah helped them, then Allah Almighty helping them to be Sahaba, companion of Rasulullah. Anyone mention their name, then everyone will say radiyallahu anhu, may Allah please by him and dress him by mercies and high ranks, Sahaba, something important. And the same for everyone of the nation of Rasulullah is something important. If he try to change himself from badness to goodness, then Rasulullah will help him. Then Allah Almighty will change him from badness to goodness. Otherwise you will remain in your bad behavior, bad manners, and you will be blocking the programming of Allah Almighty, the will of Allah Almighty, and then it will be miseries for your physical body, cursing on your physical body, and you will be dust in your grave, no more to be light or to be heavenly one, but to be a dust and trapped in the jail, in the prison today of judgment, to be questioned by Allah Almighty. And for the one who wants to be saving himself from questioning, he must be in this life try his best to change him from bad, to change himself by from badness to goodness. And Allah supporting us and Rasulullah by Ahlul Bayt al-Nabi, by Sahaba, by Awliya, the most important ones, to show us the holy ayat of the Holy Quran, where Allah Almighty saying clearly in it, فِيهِ شِفَاءٌ لِلنَّاسِ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلنَّاسِ فِيهِ رَحْمَةٌ لِلنَّاسِ. The Holy Quran, it is only hidayah, only mercies, only cureness. Every ayat, every letter, every word is only cureness for the children of Adam, not only for the nation of Rasulullah, but all children of Adam, from time of Adam, from pre-eternal, forever, without ending. The Holy Quran, the divinely words of Allah Almighty to change the one, to be a divinely one, to be cured and to be well presented in the divinely presence of Allah Almighty. The Holy Quran is the mirror for you to look. And if you have an awliya to make you to look in his mirror, then you will find whatever you have badness and what never you have a goodness. No one has a goodness at all nowadays. Everyone, all his behavior, all his manners, all his attitudes, even putting a turban, a beard, a dressing jubba, dressing sunnah, but they inside it is full with waste, his diaper full with waste, never changing himself because he doesn't want to change himself. The one who wants to change himself, not by praying you can change yourself, not by fasting you can change yourself. To change yourself only by guidance, to be guided, to have a mirror in front of you as you stand every morning, seeing your face and your body by the mirror, how to dress, how to shave, how to make yourself well appearing between people, the same you need. And for this Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said this hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, very powerful hadith. Al-mu'minu mar'ata akhihi al-mu'min. The real mu'min, the real believer, which means the awliyaullah, the Ahlul Baytul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sahaba of Rasulullah, and nowadays mostly the awliyaullah azza wa jal, they are the real mirror. Everyone of them, they are a mirror for their brotherhood in humanity to look on them to see himself and what he has bad characters and behavior. Every mu'min is a mirror for the other mu'min. You can see through him what goodness or badness you have. If you have goodness, then thank Allah Almighty. If you have badness, you must repent and to change yourself. Don't wait Allah to change you. Never Allah will change you. لا يغير الله ما بقوم. Never Allah will change a people or a one. حتى يغير ما بأنفسهم. Until they change themselves and what inside themselves from badness to goodness, then Allah will help them. Like this, Allah Almighty is swearing and making an oath on himself. And the same Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and same Awliyaullah. And for this Awliyaullah, you see them sometimes, they will be making the one joke with them, laugh, happy to be like this. Doesn't mean that you are a very good one, but means they don't want to help you because you are not helping yourself. When they will be serious and giving, scolding you, then they are really loving you because they are changing you from badness to goodness because you have started to change yourself. Then you will be able to be curing by Allah Almighty, by Rasulullah to cure you and to be dressed by reality of Islam, reality of Iman, reality of politeness, reality of good behavior. But if you are going to spend your life following your mind, then you will be totally dropped from the eyes of Allah Almighty and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The first who used his mind was Satan, Shaitan. When Allah Almighty ordering all malaika make sujood to Adam, he said, no, I don't make sujood. He used his mind. How I do sujood, bowing to someone which I am better than him. I am from fire, he is from mud and dust. I am from light. And I never put for my forehead except to my creator. How to put it for a created thing? And what happened to him? Allah cursed him, kicked him out because he changed himself. He used to be very good. But he changed himself from goodness to badness. Allah help him. And changed him to badness and cursed him and kicked him out. Like this Allah Almighty will do. So be careful. And the Satan is the example for everyone. Allah make him, employed him to be a test for everyone. To know that the one who will not change himself and to look at his mistakes and bad behavior and not to interfere in the programming of Allah Almighty and Rasulullah. In anyone you have nothing to interfere. Allah create everyone to be independent. No partnership for anyone. No advisor for anyone. Allah Almighty appointed two malaika on your shoulder to write your goodness and badness. He didn't appoint human being to be searching for your goodness and badness. He didn't appoint anyone to look what you are doing bad or wrong, but Allah appointing malaika to be witnessing you. And يوم القيامة Allah saying, يوم تأتي كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد. Every nafs, every breathing thing is going to be cue to Allah Almighty with a driver, معها سائق, a driver. And shaheed, and the one witnessing her, what she did in the life, what this nafs, what the one of us did in his life, one will be driving him forcefully in queue to the divine presence of Allah Almighty, and one will be witnessing him. Then when he will approach to be questioned in the divine presence, Allah Almighty, Allah doesn't wait from him to use his tongue and talk, but he will shut up his mouth with one flap, and he make every cell of his body, every organs of his body, the eyes to talk, the ears to talk, the hand to talk, the feet to talk, the heart to talk, everything in him to talk, witnessing that he was bad and always interfering in the programming of Allah Almighty and interfering by the decisions of Allah Almighty. Then he will be scolding his parts and his cells and organs. I want to save you. You are now witnessing me that I am going to be to Jahannam, to hell, Allah to throw me. And for this Allah promising that everyone, لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ. Allah make an oath that I am going to fill hell, Jahannam, by all, jami', all, by all creations. No one is going to be saved from Jahannam. Only whom to be saved, the prophets, the Siddiqs, أُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ. They will be the one whom they will be saved. And for this you will see Allah Almighty created 7 hells and created 8 paradises. 1 paradise for the one who will never pass by hell or enter to hell. And these are these. النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. The صالحين mean the awliya, the Ahlul Bayt al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the shaheed, and the siddiqs, and the prophets. They are protected by Allah Almighty. And the 7 paradises, Allah created for them a 7 hell so that everyone must be showered. Even he say, La ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah. He will enter to Jahannam. He will be well cleaned in the washing machine. Then Allah will send him to another 7 Jahannam for drying him. Then another 7 Jahannam, 7 hell to be ironing him, the Malaika. Then he will send him to the 7 paradises. While up neighborhood of Allah Almighty, the 8th paradise, these are protected by Allah Almighty. Nevertheless, will be entering to Jahannam. And for this Allah Almighty saying, لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ. All they are going to be full in Jahannam, human being and jinn. Allah saying all of them, if he said completely, will be completely, all of them mean also the ones of the 8 paradise will go to Jahannam. But he say, Allah didn't say completely, he say ajma'in, all of them, he make a little bit different, that there is whom they are protected by Allah Almighty. And he say, أُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ. And the one who follow these 4 types, نبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين, and he will be following them in this life like the dog, as a dog, like the dog of Ahlul Kahf. How he is an animal. We are animals also. Even we are honored by Allah Almighty as children of Adam alayhi salam. But this for our essence, for our humanity, for our soul. But we are make our physical body to be animal, animalistic body, to be satanic body, to be following this shaitan, traps by satanic world, to be like an animal. And for this Allah saying, the one who follow in this life, like this dog who follow these believers, these ministers, believers, whom reject to worship the king, and they worshiped only Allah Almighty, and he was barking and following them, they were throwing stones on him because he's barking, so that the soldier not to recognize them or to find them. He was bleeding. They also thrown stones until he was totally fractured, all his bones, bleeding, and still loving them and following them until they reached to the open of the cave. Then Allah Almighty descending, leave this dog to enter with you, because totally he is dying and bleeding and fractured and all broken and still loving you. This love of him enough to be crowded with you in the day of Yawm al-Qiyam, day of judgment. Where all animals, after questioning, Allah will send them to send this dog will enter to Jannah, will be purified and enter to Jannah. Allah saying in the Holy Quran, and Allah Almighty giving it as an example. The one who will be making his animalistic body to be like a dog following Ahlu Baytul Nabi, Awliyaullah, Sahabati Rasulullah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to be humble enough like a dog. Even they will throw stones on him, they lead him, and he's still following them, then he will be the one to be crowded with the one whom loved, whom he used to love, whom everyone now, they are insulting them, Ahlu Baytul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He loves Awliyaullah, whom everyone now say no Awliya, they curse Awliya. He loves Sahaba of Rasulullah, whom now the Shia people and all these type of people cursing all Sahaba. He loves and following Rasulullah, Muhammad Rasulullah. Hey, how do you think Allah Almighty is going to crowd this whom showing all humbleness like a dog, animal, following and loving them? He will be crowded and he will be in the eighth paradise without entering to these seven jahals at all. Because Allah saying, Ulaik, those, they will be with whom Allah granted them and honored them, النبيين والمرسلين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. These are the ayat in the Holy Quran. Why you don't read, recite, and be using these medicines of these ayat on yourself? No one now is using, no more ikhlas for Allah Almighty. No one now dare to say one word of haqq. They are all scared. They want to make themselves polite with people so that everyone to be loving them. But a real awliya, he doesn't care. وَدُّ لَوْ تُدْهِنُوا فَيُدْهِنُونَ. They, the non-believers, the kuffar, they used to make Rasulullah to make polite with them and to make as if, how you say, مَسْحْجُوخ, to make the one as if he is happy by what they are doing, but he refused. He was always showing them their mistake, their badness, because they want him to be following them even by so few politeness that they will then be claiming that they are something. Yeah, nothing. No one is something. Only Rasulullah is everything. Only Ahlul Bayt is everything. Only Sahaba is everything. Only Awliyaullah is everything. And all over the real everything, whom all this everything existing by him, and he is the all in all, and he is the one in everyone, Allah Almighty, and no one else. And Allah saying, Kullu man alayha fan, all of you are going to be totally finished and be buried, and you will be dust. Awliya will be light, Sahaba light, Ahlul Bayt light, Prophets light, while all common ones, they will be dust, jail, and Allah will call them. To whom the kingdom today? Where are the tyrants? Where is Fir'aun? Where is Namrud? Where all the tyrants? Where these whom they are forcing people to do as they like, ruling people, whom they are catching people to make them slaves for themselves, and the people happy to be slave, and they say we are from this family or that family. They are proud by their titles and families. At that time, no more titles, no more families, no more tyrants, no more kings, no more ministers, no more president, no more tyrants. Finish. No one to answer Allah Almighty. All dust under the feet of Allah Almighty. Then Allah will answer himself by himself. لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدُ الْقَهَارُ. To whom the kingdom today? For me, Allah, الْوَاحِدُ الْقَهَارُ, he said. For me, the one, the lonely one, the Ahad. Al-Qahhad, whom he diminished all, no more to be existing or appearing under his feet as a dust. And still we are stubborn, following our mind and desires. They say the mind the most important. No, mind not important. The heart is the important. And for this Allah Almighty dressed iman to the heart. He didn't dress it to the mind. Imam Azam, four mazhab. The four mazhab. Not one mazhab. The four mazhab. One, Rasulullah ordering them to follow a guidance, an awliya, a spiritual one to lead them. So they obey because order of Rasulullah. They saw in dream Rasulullah ordering Sayyidina Abu Hanifa, go and take a bay'ah from Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq and follow him. So Sayyidina Abu Hanifa went to Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq. Sayyidina Imam al-Shafi ordered to go to Sayyidina Shayban al-Ra'i. Sayyidina Imam Malik was ordered also to go to Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq by Rasulullah, and Sayyidina Ahmad ibn Hanbal was ordered to go to Bishr al-Hafr. All of them, they used to have an awliya, a guidance to guide them. So the first thing Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq, he told Sayyidina Imam Mu'azzam Abu Hanifa, how you put your mazhab, how you put your school, how you put your as a reformer. He told him, I balance everything according to my mind, then according to the hadith and the ayat. Then he told him the first to use his mind was shaitan. And Allah Almighty putting iman, putting divinely knowledge in the heart. He didn't put it in the mind. The heart is the heart disk where all divine, the godly world inside, while the mind is only the screen and the keyboard. From the keyboard you can put what you want to put as information, and you send them to the heart, and the heart as representing the divinely godly words of Allah Almighty and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be computerizing them, finalizing them, and sending them back to the screen to be seen by you, which is the mind. But if you don't send to your heart and you use directly your mind, then you will be totally a loser. And for this, he said, Sayyidina Imam Abu Hanifa, if not 2 years I met before I died Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq, I will be in a bad end, I will be a loser. These 2 years with Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq made me to realize the reality and to reach to the spiritualities and realities. And he changed in these 2 years all his mazhab. Instead to build it up on his mind, he built it up on his heart. And on what Allah and Rasulullah sent into his heart from the wisdom of the ayat and the clearness of the ayat and the hadith of Rasulullah. The same for Sayyidina Imam al-Shafi, same for Sayyidina Malik, same for Sayyidina Ahmad ibn Hanbal. So nowadays, why people so proud and the ulama not to accept awliya to guide them? Sayyidina Imam al-Shafi, he was a big scholar, knowledgeable, reformer, imam of mazhab, and he was following a shepherd, totally illiteral, knowing, never writing, but Allah making his heart to be a godly station, and Rasulullah make his heart to be Muhammad station. For all divinely knowledge at that time, which Allah want to give to the ulama and to the people to guide them, to cure them, to be a mirror for them, to see their sickness and to change themselves, that Allah will change them and to go all by good end. Well, these are the main important thing of the Sohbah, and for this the Naqshbandi way built, and all Sufi ways, they are built up in the Sohbah, on Sohbah, and on Zikr and Khatmul Khawaja Khan. Because ذكر الله to say لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله, you will be covering all, even the tiniest of three eternal knowledge before beginning, without beginning, forever without ending, the divinely godly knowledge of Allah Almighty, إلا إله إلا الله. Never one tiny drop of knowledge is not found in La ilaha illallah. And it represents the uniqueness of Allah Almighty. It represents the divinely essence of Allah Almighty. It represents the divinely absolute identity of Allah Almighty. It represents the divinely hidden treasure, which Allah say, I used to be a hidden treasure. When I want to be known, my will to be known, I create creation, and by me they know me. And when you mention Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is the mirror of La ilaha illallah, is the ocean of wahdaniyya, the ocean of oneness of Allah Almighty, where everyone can in La ilaha illallah see himself in this mirror, to see whom he is from Allah Almighty, whom he is in that ocean of uniqueness. What is his light in that ocean? How much he is so close or far away? How much he is swimming in that ocean of uniqueness? And he is the divinely godly word of lights, the example of the lights of Allah Almighty, the divinely godly words of light of Allah Almighty. Allah presented it by to be looks like the divinely godly word Allah created from his divinely godly word of light, Allah appearing, and the divinely godly word of light called Muhammadun Rasulullah coming by the picture and figure of Rasulullah, from where every light and manifestation then was appearing from this ocean, from this mirror, so that they are be able then to be appearing in the divinely godly world of attributes, divinely godly words of names, divinely godly words of deeds, divinely godly words of love, divinely godly words, all these descending to the day of judgment, then to be also ascending on all these divinely godly words forever of Allah Almighty by Muhammadun Rasulullah. Because he is this boat, he is this ship which Allah Almighty mentioning in Surah Yasin, that he is the ship whom Allah loaded it by all lights and manifestation to be carrying and sailing them in the ocean of oneness of wahdaniyya from three eternal forever without ending. وحملنا ذريتهم في الفلك المشحون. Allah is saying, وحملنا ذريتهم في الفلك المشحون. I loaded and carried all manifestations and all these atoms and all descendants of it in this huge uncreated boat, godly boat, divinely boat, sailing from pre-eternal forever in the ocean of wahdaniyya, of oneness of Allah Almighty, to reach his destination. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Because Allah Almighty all saying, all of you, Rasulullah, my beloved Muhammad, returning you to me, to my almighty hand, praise be to me, whom are the reality of every light and atoms and created thing by me is in my hand. The malakut of everything is in my hand, and to me you are returning. فَسُبْحَانَ الَّذِي بِيَدِهِ مَلَكُوتُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ مَلَكُوتُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. And for this Rasulullah saying to return us to the almighty hand of Allah Almighty, without how to be dressed by our realities, by our essence, by our greatest name of Allah Almighty. And like this, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is carrying, making shafa, but also making Sahaba and teaching and advising the Sahaba, the Sahaba, to make the one to change from badness to goodness so that he will be upgraded to be crowded with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with Siddiq, with prophets, with Siddiqs, with Shuhada, with Saliheen. Not to be with the common one like animal, but to be an animal like the dog of Ahlul Kahf. How much they finishing him, fracturing him, bleeding him, and he's still following until Allah descending Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam as a good tiding for this dog who has nothing, neither prayer or fasting, to be Ahlul Jannah crowded with these people of Ahlul Kahf. How about us, mankind, whom we are addressing ourselves by an animalistic state, and also proud, doesn't want to follow Rasulullah, doesn't follow Awliyaullah and Ahlul Bayt, doesn't loving them, and even we say we love only by tongue, not by surviving the Sunnah of Rasulullah, not by surviving the teaching of Awliyaullah. Instead, we are interfering in everyone, cursing everyone, questioning everyone, controlling everyone, blocking the programming of Allah Almighty in everyone, that we are making all this corruption and mess in the earth, that now you are everyone saying the people cursing their rulers and the rulers cursing their people, as Rasulullah predicted at the end of the time, the people will curse their rulers and the rulers will be cursing the people. And the real mu'min at that time, he will be asking, oh Allah Almighty, make me to be dying and be buried under the earth, better to me to see all this over the earth. And this all in these 10 times, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, in the daily practicing all this knowledge. Then for Shafa'ah of Rasulullah, that Rasul, as Allah Almighty, when you say La ilaha illallah 10 times and Muhammadur Rasulullah, Allah will take you from the darkness of your satanic and animalistic world to the light of Allah Almighty, to the divinely light. The same Rasulullah, by 10 times Salawat al-Sharifah, will pray on you and take you from the darkness of your animalistic physical body to the light of Rasulullah in you, and to make you upgraded, that you will be dressed by lights of Rasulullah, Shafa'ah of Rasulullah, and one prayer from Rasulullah better than all your worshipping and prayers forever, from time of starting till forever without ending. One prayer from Rasulullah better than all your worshipping. All your worshipping, every minute is cursed by Allah Almighty, as 2000 years Shaitan was worshipping, making sujood to Allah Almighty. Heaven, earth is no one footstep is except a sujood to Shaitan. Then at the end he was cursed, and Allah cursed all his worshipping. Like this our worshipping. And Allah saying in the Holy Quran, وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. What about when I will be showing all of you all your worshipping and the practicing and all your good deeds to be haba'an mansura, to be dust and spread in the air, no more to be balanced or to be appreciated or valuable, because your badness, your making your physical body which I created to be pure and honored, you make your essence to be an animal and to be a satanic essence, following Shaitan and following your desires. And like this is 10 times Salawat al-Sharifa, enough for the one to protect him. And then, time of Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salam, there was an old woman, she was a believer. She told, oh Prophet Nuh alayhi salam, when the flood will be going on, come, I am in the cave with my cow, bring me to your boat. And like this Allah was saying, وَحَمَلْنَاهُمْ فِي الْفُلْكِ الْمَشْهُ وَخَلَقْنَا لَهُمْ مِنْ مِثْلِهِ مَا يَرْكَبُونَ. And I teach them And I create for them a boat looks like that boat which sailing in the ocean of Wahdaniya, which called Muhammadur Rasulullah. And these are the boats now, they are sailing, and the ships, and Sayyidina Nuh ships. And like this, for some reason, Sayyidina Nuh, he forgot this mu'min, believer, woman, lady, and she was sitting on the cave, door of the cave, waiting, now Prophet Nuh will come by me, now Prophet Nuh will come by me, but never coming. Then after the flood is finished, and the boat was landed on the mountain of Judi, and the earth took all the water, and the heavens stopped raining, the skies, he remember about her. Then he say, I better to go and to make a good Islamic funeral for her, to pray on her and to bury her. He reached to her place, to the cave, but he was so surprised. Even he was a prophet, but he was not using miracle. They say miracles. Like this, visions or miracle. If prophets not using miracles. And so he saw, surprising that this woman still sitting on the door of this cave and waiting Prophet Nuh to come. And when he came, he told her, he told them, now is the time to go to the boat. He told her, how? No one remained except me and this 70, 80 believers and the animals, and the flood is finished and everything finished, and no one, all this earth totally, all people died. How you still alive? She told, I don't know, I am waiting for you. How? You still living and the water not covering you. Even his son was drowned by the water, because the water coming 70 yards over all highest mountains of the earth. And this woman was staying still on the door of this cave down of the mountain. She told him, well, I don't know, but one day I sent my cow, and but was coming back full with mud. I thought it is a heavy rain in the city, but I didn't take it seriously. Then she told him that one moon, full moon face, full with lights, dressed by lights, and he was lights, passing by me, and he told me, oh, old woman, ya ajuz, old woman, say after me. And what to say after you? He say, say after me and memorize it also. Ala ashraf al-alamina Sayyidina Muhammadin al-salawat. Ala afdal al-alamina Sayyidina Muhammadin al-salawat. على أكمل العالمين سيدنا محمد الصلوات صلوات الله تعالى وملائكته وأنبيائه ورسله وجميع خلق على محمد وعلى آل محمد عليه وعليهم السلام ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. ورضي الله تبارك وتعالى عن أصحاب رسول الله وعن التابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. عندي repeat it until well memorized it, and he say, as much as you can spend all day and night doing nothing except reciting this Salawat al-Sharifa. She told him, who is Muhammad? We never heard by this name. This happened. Then she was asking Sayyidina Nuh, who is Muhammad? He told her, this is the beloved to Allah Almighty. He is the sealed of Prophet from whom all of us, we wish to Allah Almighty to make us a one of his common nation, to be servant even for his common nation, common ones in his nation. And he is the real Prophet, and we are all like servants to him. He is the Lord of us, and all our light of prophecy from him. And she told him, I was repeating it day and night, and for this Salawatu Sharifa and Ayat Branche and Mawlana say, Allah save her from the flood as he saved Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, Prophet Ibrahim, from the fire. It was paradise for him and cool and safe. This flood was for this woman by this salawat wa salam on Rasulullah was as a paradise and safety for her. And when she said at Maulana, they end all this daily practicing by it. Why? Because now a day till the appearance of Sayyidina al-Mahdi, till the day of judgment, nothing will be saving the one except to say this Salawatu Sharifa at least 5 times after every prayer, 1 time, and 1 time with the daily practicing, at least 6 times. And how much more he will say it, how much more he will say it, how much in every moment will be saved, protected, and will be in defense of Muhammadun Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Rasulullah will upgrade him to be in defense and protection of Allah Almighty, divine, the presence of Allah Almighty. And for this was ended this daily practicing by it, for the protection for all whom following the line of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu, Sayyidina Ali radiyallahu anhu, and all Sahaba and Ahlu Bayt al-Nabi following the line of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whom is representing the line of Allah Almighty. May Allah forgive us, mercy us. Allah, 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 Aziz, Allah, 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 Kareem, Allah, 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 Subhanallah, Allah, 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 Sultan Allah. You are Sultan, Allah Almighty, and we are your weaker servants. Oh Allah Almighty, forgive us, mercy us. Change us from badness to goodness and give us good ending, Ya Rabbi Allah. And cure us. And cure all the sick ones of the nation of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And take off all sickness and bless us by pureness and healing, Godly healing, Muhammad Rasulullah healing, Ahl Bayt al-Nabi healing, Sahaba healing, Grand Shaykh Mawlana Shaykh and all Grand Shaykh Sayyidina Shah al-Naqshband and Awliyaullah healing and Sahib al-Zaman healing and Prophet healing, Muhammad al-Habib, Muhammad al-Fatih. Okay. Now we finish it. This is the end of it. This is the end of the daily practicing which Grand Sheikh started 2-3 months ago. Now, time to finish it. All full with secrets and wisdoms. But for the one who search for wisdoms and secrets, and the one who searching for to poison other will remain poisoned. Never will be changed. May Allah forgive us and mercy us. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إلى شرف النبي سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. أبو رضا سيدنا ذو الحقان الذي كان من الرحمن. سادات النقش بن الصديق. سيدنا أبو بكر الصديق وعثمان بن فاطمة سيدنا حسن بن علي. صحابة رسول النبي الصديق بن عشاء الله والصالح وضياء الناس. على أبو النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الحمد لله عز وجل. لله تعالى الفاتحة. I am very thankful to Her Highness Raja Arena, whom she was behind bringing me here. She was the one, and also her mother, our beloved Queen Concubinon, and our beloved His Majesty Tuanku Muizzuddin Nazrin Shah. They are the one sponsoring and bringing me to this country and arranging a place for me to stay, and also for the Sri Lankan people, Mr. Sabri and his family, Mrs. Qadir and all her family, her sons, Dr. Husni, Muhammad Ahmed, and her sister, daughters, Aisha, and all the daughters, mashallah, and all their grandchildren. They are the ones sponsoring us here and in Sri Lanka and all over, and Dr. Alawi in Johor also, and to Singapore. May Allah bless all of them and give them unimaginable godly good tidings, Muhammad good tidings, and godly rewards. Muhammad rewards, healthy long life, well protected, inshallah, loved by all people, loved by awliyaullah, by Ahlul Bayt al-Nabi, loved by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and all prophets, loved by Allah Almighty, to be beloved to all of them, and to be beloved to all whom they look at their faces, to enter to Jannah, inshallah. Rahmat al-Habib, Rahmat al-Fatih. And thankful too much to Sheikh Ghazlan and his son-in-laws and to Osman and to Qasim, whom all they are working in spreading this teaching, otherwise it will remain in its place, but you are broadcasting it and streaming it live and sending it everywhere, and like this Allah reward all of you inshallah and your families by endless inshallah rewarding also and high ranks inshallah. Bihurmat Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Start saying Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Hurmat al-Fatiha. Allah bless the soul of Sultan Azman Shah bin Khadija, and Allah so bless the soul of great also Shaykh Raja Ashmah Shah Waliullah, whom they started in this country all this plant and now giving these three fruits. Alhamdulillah, people coming by godly power from Allah Almighty. Always new faces you are seeing, Alhamdulillah. Allah upgrade them and make them in the highest rank, inshallah. Sultan Aslan Shah and Shaykh Raja Ashmah Shah Waliullah, and protect all their families. Allah bless all of the royal family and all whom murids of Mawlana Sheikh Nazim and all whom they are connected with Tariqatul Naqshbandiyyah Al-Aliyah. Allah protect them and upgrade them and change all of us to goodness and to good end, and take us to be neighborhood to Rasulullah and Grand Sheikh Mawlana Sheikh, neighborhood to Allah Almighty. في مقعد صدق عند مليك مقتدر بحرمة الحبيب بحرمة الفاتحة. فلن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. فاتحة. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. في عصرنا وعلى